Hey guys! In the background, you can hear the final patch I've built for this week's contest. The chosen module was the Thunderpole Oscillator from Triggerfish. It's a really interesting oscillator, but unfortunately, it's also really heavy on the CPU, so I could use just one. And this is how I've built the patch. Let's start. Okay, so here we have clocked, our main clock. We have the oscillator, Thunderpole. We have a delay, we have a reverb. I have a glass of wine, Germany's finest. Cheers. And let's start. So this oscillator is, it's an interesting oscillator actually. It has a dampening knob, which will also change its frequency, its pitch. It's a self-oscillating and it has the self-frequency. This is what I saw in the sort of a manual they have on the website. We have the input gain, level gain, frequency and dampening CV inputs. And like it says in the manual, it works best when you drive a different oscillator through it. So let's try this and see where it will take us. Let's have another mono channel here. Let's connect everything and let's choose. Like you can see, this oscillator is pretty heavy on my CPU. So I think in this patch, this week, I will use just one module. Just one oscillator or one of those oscillators. So let's see, let's choose a different oscillator. Let me see, let's take the FM operator. It's one of my favorite oscillators. It sounds amazing and it's really simple. It has also a built-in envelope generator and VCA and feedback and everything what you need. So let's see how this sounds like. Let's just connect the FM operator to the input of the Thunderpole oscillator or Thunderpole oscillator and connect this to the mixer. Let's see how this sounds like. Change the frequency a bit. Ooh. So it has the effect, it's a self-oscillating oscillator. And you just say change the frequency, it's like changing the cutoff point. So here the sound is brighter and here it's darker, and you can hear also the resonance. You can hear it. So let's do this. Let's turn this down for a second and let's take an sequencer. Let's choose a sequencer. Which sequencer shall we use? Let's take the grid sequencer. This is the most, where is it now? The grid sequencer from JW Modules. Another schluck. It's a really intuitive sequencer. It has its own built-in quantizer also. We can set, let's choose a different scale. Let's take Phrygian. Where is it? Phrygian, C Phrygian. Where are you? Mixolydia. Here you go. C Phrygian. Okay, let's choose C Phrygian. Let's connect. Let's have already a nice mult from Bog Audio. Also, let's take the output from the grid sequencer, connect it to the input of the mult, and from there once to the FM operator. And let me think, let's do this also. Let's go to 21 kHz and take the pitch tools and connect our output from the grid sequencer through the mult to the pitch tools, and from there to the frequency input of the VDP oscillator. And let's take, with this module here, we can change the pitch or we can change the voltage coming in the volt per octave input. So let's take it up 7 semitones higher in pitch. So this pitch will be higher 7 semitones from this here, from the FM operator. And let's tune in a few notes here. Let's change also the range of the oscillator, take it down a bit so it's not so high. And let's connect our clock. Let's see, let's take the first clock to the right arrow and let's turn our volume back on. Let's take the BPM a bit higher and another schluckle. Okay, and let's do this. Let's take the gate output from the grid sequencer and connect it to the FM operator, the gate input of the FM operator, and turn on the envelope for the level. And turn down the attack because this is a really short trigger. Make it more snappy. Sustain all the way down. And this is already a nice effect this oscillator is giving. This is really nice. Let's see what happens when I turn the damping. Oh. Okay. That was cool. Okay, so let's connect also the this voltage that comes out from the grid sequencer. Let's connect it also to the damping CV input. Yes. We have a nice rhythm going on. Let's see what we can do with the delay. Let's turn the crossfade here down and turn on the volume a bit. And let's see, let's try to create a sort of a chorus effect or something like a chorus or a widening. Let's take this down to let's say 40 milliseconds. And the right channel, let's take down to 52. Turn on the feedback. Let's turn down the reverb for a second, see how this sounds like, just the delay. Very nice. Okay, decay a bit down and a bit more reverb. And let's see what happens when I sync the delay with our main clock. And let's sync the delay and see what happens when we modulate the delay. Oh, that's some good wine. Let's see how we can modulate the delay. We can use a sample and hold, which will be nice. Let's see, let's take brains. I like brains from the geodesics modules. Brains, let's change it to the dark matter edition. And let's take let's connect it to the clock. But this is also the same clock, so let's do this. Let's take another mult and connect the clocks through the mult. Very nice. And now we can connect also brains. Let's connect it to the first clock and multiply it by 2, let's say. No, let's divide it by 2, actually. It's a bit slower. Let's divide it by 4, actually. No, by 5. Okay, that's it. And now let's do this. Let's move it a bit to the left and let's use what we can use. Let's take the Befaco slew limiter. Let's take the slew limiter and let's do this. Let's take actually two. No, you know we will not use a slew limiter. Let's do this. Let's turn. Let's take the clock to brains to the lower part, because here we have, if we turn on the range here, the noise range, this part here has a range, if I'm not mistaken, minus or negative 1 to positive 1 volt, which is pretty a narrow range. And let's take the pink noise output and connect it to the left delay or time CV input. See if something happens. The range is not enough, I guess. So let's take the. Oh no, it's changing. It's changing. Oh yes. Oh yes. Okay, and let's take the. This is the blue or the red? I don't see. No, this is the pink, this is the red, and this is the blue. Let's take the blue noise output and connect it to the right channel of the delay. And we have some movement here. Yes. Let's see what happens when I play with the self frequency knob here of the Van der Pol oscillator. Okay. You can play with this later live. Let's take also the output from the grid sequencer. Let's connect it also. So this mult is really cool because it's normaled. The two sections are normaled, which means that if nothing is connected to the input of the second mult, then the signals are just they keep coming out of the second section here. So we can just continue taking voltage out of this section here. So let's take it to the sustain CV input. And connect it, and not connect it, and turn the sustain all the way up. So now it's modulating also the sustain of the notes. Higher notes, more sustain, lower notes, less sustain. Okay, and let's turn down the reverb just a bit. Cut the low frequencies a bit. Let's turn up the modulation depth so we have even more movement. And let's add a bass. Let's add a bass. This is a sort of a repetitive melody, which is nice, but let's add a nice bass and I will tell you what I will do. Let's see, what can we do actually? Let's take another. Let's put a blank here. Let's take another oscillator. Let's choose another oscillator. Shall I take the even VCO? Let's take the even VCO. You know why? Why not? Yes. So let's turn the octaves down. Let's say to 8 feet or foot. How do you say this? Foot or feet? Ah, I think it's foot. Okay. So let's take this down and let's do this. We have sample and hold here already, brain. So let's take the white noise output. Let's connect it directly to the pulse width modulation CV input. And let's take tangents like always. Oh, I have to use just three modules. Now I remember. Do I just three modules. So let's take tangents, the three. Modus version, and let's take, you know what, I feel like something I don't know, we'll see, something a bit more jumpy and with a rhythm. So let's take also slap, also from Volt, the free modules version. Okay, let's connect a square wave to the low pass input of tangents, from the output to the input of the VCA section in slap. Let's have another. Oh, look at this! Look at this here. I'm already hitting almost the limit here. Okay, never mind. Let's take a mono channel and connect it to the other channels and connect the output of slap to the input of the mono channel. And we need a gate. Let's see. What can we do? Let's take the phrase sequence, see if I can make this work. Look at this, my CPU is running low. Okay, dark skin, here I come. Tum tum ta ta tum, how can I make this? Let's see. Let's make it 8 steps long. Connect the CV output to the volt per octave input of the even VCO. The first gate to the gate input of slap. And. Let's run this sequencer clock input to our clock. I think it's the main clock. It will be enough. Let's run this. Okay, let's set it on not attach, and let's set the first note to, let's mute this for a second, and I think we should make this, let's disconnect this mono channel and connect it after the delay, because I don't want this delay modulation on the bass. So let me just make the connections really quick. Oh yes, but I don't want. Okay, here I want B flat. Here I want B flat. Let's see if it works. Boom, boom, boom. I will do something else. Let's see if I can. Let's take it out of the main clock and connect it to our second clock and multiply it by 4. And here let's change the just a second, another schluck wine. Change the resolution to be times 4. So now we have it, and let's unmute it. And here I want it to be C. No, here I want it to be still B flat, and here I want it. No, you know what? Let's make it a 7-step sequence. Let's make it a 7-step sequence. This can be maybe more interesting. Let's change the gate to be something like this. Let's see if this works. Yes. Okay, let's copy this sequence, copy to the second sequence, and let's this is not what I wanted, let's transpose it. Seven semitones or five? Okay, let's start with 7. And let's copy this to the third sequence. And let's transpose it 5 semitones. Lower, I think. Wow, this is bad. Okay, 7, it's so minus 2, I think it's 5 semitones higher. Yeah. Okay, and let's see, let's go to the first sequence. The first sequence will play. Five times, was it? Let's change it to 4 times. The mode to forward 4. Then let's go to the second sequence. Let's take it to forward 2. And let's go. But this is not working. Let's transpose it differently. Okay, I think I will use just both sequences. So let's turn it to song mode. And let's see, let's take the length, 2 sequences. The first one is the first one, the second one is the second sequence. Yes. Let's reset everything so it works together. Reset from the sequencer to the reset output of clocked. Hey. And the reset of the grid sequencer to the reset output of clock. Let's reset. Bzzup. Okay, one more time. The first sequence has to be one more time. I don't think there is 5 times, there is just 4. Okay, let's see if we leave it like this, what happens. You know what, let's just leave it in the first sequence. And we can transpose it in a different way. I think the whine. Is affecting me. And let's turn the resonance on. Oh, yes, a bit more drive. How come it's so dirty? It's this. I know why. Wow, this is really nice. I didn't connect a clock to the clock input here of brains, which means that it's outputting noise, white noise, to the pulse width modulation CV input, which gives it gives this crunchy sound. Listen to this. Oh, very cool. Yes, you see, this is serendipity. Happy accidents, and I'm really happy now. Okay. Okay, let's see what we can do. Maybe this I can play live. You know what? Let's connect. Can I use a MIDI keyboard here in this contest? I don't know. I will not use one, but let's say that I can, or let's say that I cannot, because I will not use one. So never mind. Let's say, let's connect another sample and hold here the white noise from the lower section to the cutoff point of the filter of tangents and open the attenuator. See what happens. I need something quicker, actually. I need something a bit more. And let's take another sample and hold. Let's go to Bog Audio. I think they have also a nice sample and hold. Yeah, dual sample and hold. Okay, so let's take a trigger. Let's disconnect this. Let's take a trigger from the third clock. And let's, oh, we have the second clock multiplied by 4, actually. You know what, let's do this. Let's take the second mult here. Let's reset it again and connect it once to the sequencer and once to the sample and hold. What's this? Okay, and once to the sample and hold. And then the input will take another noise. Let's take the blue noise from brains. And let's take the output to the cutoff point of the filter. Let's close the attenuator a bit. And let's even do this. Let's take utilities from audible instruments or kinks. And connect the output from the sample and hold. The output from the sample and hold to the input of the invert and rectify, and take the full rectified signal, which means that all the negative voltage is away and they are all being mirrored upwards to the positive voltage. And let's take this to the input, sieve input of the cutoff point. Yes, this is nice. This is what I wanted. Let's turn the attack a bit up of slap because there's this click. Yes. Now the click is away. And let's do the same. Also here, let's take, shall I take another mult? I don't know, I don't have a lot of CPU. No, let's leave it like this. I want to create a lead. Let's create a lead sound, a sort of a melody on top. Let's see, what takes less CPU? The grid sequencer or the phrase sequencer? I think the grid sequencer. Let's duplicate the grid sequencer. Where is it? Here. And let's take... what will be nice? Let's go to 21 kHz and take the palm loop. Let's add another stereo channel. Connect it also to our main mixer. And let's see, do I want it to be... Yeah, let's leave it where it is now. So it's also... Sorry, so it's also modulated with a delay. Let's take the output of this grid sequencer, connect it to the volt per octave input of the palm loop. And let's take a much slower clock. Let's take it, let's say, divided by 6, connect it to the forward arrow of the grid sequencer. And now let's take two waves. Let's take a sine wave. Let's take a square wave from the, this is, I think it's two octaves slower. So it's a sub oscillator, it's a square wave. Opalach. No, I think it's one octave lower. So let's take the triangle wave. And let's make it one octave higher. Yes. Ah, yeah, this is nice. This is very nice. Let's see, what else can we do? I think think soon my computer will say no more, please, no more modules. So let's see what else can we do. You know what? Let's connect it to the reverse arrow and see what happens. Yeah, I think I like it. What else can we do? I wish you could add a sort of an arpeggiator or a hi-hat. Wow, a hi-hat will be crazy here. A hi-hat will be really nice. Let's try to add a hi-hat and see if my computer lets me. And let's take... what should we take? How is the fundamental sequencer? Is it heavy on CPU? Bit, but not so much. Let me tell you why. Shall I take this? Maybe that we take topograph. Let's see. Let's try topograph. See how much this takes. Okay, topograph. We have times 4 clock, which is going to the mult here. So let's connect the times 4, the multiplied by 4 clock to the topograph. Right click on topograph and change it to 4PPQN. And turn it all the way down so it's on external clock. Run it, connect the reset to our reset of the clock so we can reset everything and everything starts together. Do you think I can use the hi-hat from the Hora modules? Because this is an amazing hi-hat. It's a live Hira. I wrote Hira. Hora. Let's see if my computer lets me. Hi-hat. This is a pretty heavy module, you can see, but it sounds amazing. Oh, look at this. Let's see if this works. So let's take the trigger from the first channel here of topograph, of grids. This is originally grids from multiple instruments connected to the trigger input. The accent, let's take the second channel actually. Oh, this is my computer telling me, no, you cannot. Let's give it a try anyway. The third channel to the open hi-hat trigger. And then, did I add another mono module? No, so let's add it here after the delay, before the reverb. Let's see if this works. Mono, let's connect everything together. And connect the hi-hat also, and now take a listen. And let's do this. Let's take the open hi-hat intensity less, to be less played less times. Yes, computer, I understand, leave me alone. Chaos all the way up. Let's change the maps a bit. Oh, and let's turn also the accent a bit down and the hi-hat a bit up. I know, computer, I understand. Let's turn the CPU meter off. I think it takes also a bit CPU. Let's turn the volume a bit down. Okay, I think it works. Oh yes, I think we have our patch for this week. What do you think? I don't know, it sounds nice. Let's open the cutoff of the bass and hear this sandy sound. Oh, baby. Very nice, I think I'm done here. Let's zoom out a bit, let's see. 3U, 62. not so many modules, but look, if I turn on again the CPU meter, take a look at this oscillator, the Van der Pol oscillator, which is really interesting, I have to say, it's interesting. Let's listen again just to this oscillator. If I take out the delay and the reverb, it is interesting, you have to say. I mean, I'm sure you can do much more with it, but look at it, it's peaking at 200 milliseconds. On my system, it's much too much. And it's a shame, actually, because it's, again, it sounds nice. So let's turn off the CPU meter and turn on the reverb and the delay. Now what I will do, I will turn the volume up. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know in the comments if I should continue making these videos. I thought every week there is a patch for the contest. And I really do miss making the improvised patch tutorials. And this is a sort of improvised patch tutorial actually. And I hope soon to get also a better setup, a better computer, so we can make it even longer and add even more modules. And that's it, guys. Again, thanks for watching. I'm going to turn on all the different channels, turn up the volume, so we can listen to this a bit. I will rearrange stuff here, make it tidy up a bit. And record it, and this will be the patch. Oh, let me just save this also. Whoop, save. So this will be also the patch for the next week for the contest. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.